Revelation 17, verse 1. Now God gave us a description of this man of sin and the great tribulation right in the book. So you'll know, he even give you what colors he wear. Revelation 17, verse 1. Go ahead, brother.
And there came one of the seven angels which had the seven veils, and talked with me, saying unto me, Come hither, I will show unto thee the judgment of the great whore that sitteth upon many waters.
Who is that? Go ahead.
With whom the kings of the earth have committed fornication, and the inhabitants of the earth have been made drunk with the wine of her fornication.
When he's talking about being made drunk of the wine of the fornication, meaning that these people are drunk with their doctrine, their knowledge,
right,
what they give us. Like, we drunk with holidays, Valentine's Day, Mother's Day, all this stuff we drunk with because we don't see the Passover. We don't see the holy days or anything. We don't see none of that. All we see is just what the world give us. Go ahead, brother.
Verse 3. So he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness, and I saw a woman sit upon a scarlet-colored beast, full of names of blasphemy, having seven heads and ten horns.
He seen a woman sit on a scarlet beast. I'm trying to find this color for y'all. Go ahead.
And the woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet color, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls,
mm-hmm,
having a golden cup in her hand full of abomination and filthiness of her fornication.
So this woman, meaning that it's a church, when God deals with a woman, or he put it like in a symbolic term, he's talking about, like I said, I'm coming back for a bride. And that bride is what? The church. So this woman he's talking about right here, it's the same thing as a religious organization, and they have wear these certain colors that he's going to reveal who they are by the colors. Mm. Because most of everybody in here is a drunkard. Everybody in them worship him. And some of us still worship him. But go ahead. Listen to what he said here.
Verse 5.
Mm-hmm.
And upon her forehead.
Wait, go back up to verse 4. Verse 4.
And the woman was arrayed in purple.
Excuse me. Verse 3. Go ahead.
Verse 3.
Uh-huh.
So he carried me away in the spirit into the wilderness.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw a woman sit upon a scarlet-colored beast,
mm-hmm,
full of names of blasphemy, having seven heads and ten horns.
So he sat upon a scarlet, meaning the color. This is what their attire is. This is the colors they wear. Go ahead.
And the woman was arrayed in purple and scarlet color, and decked with gold and precious stones and pearls.
Wait a minute now. He give us color. What are they wearing right here? All these different types of colors. He's telling you who this man of sin is and where he come from, which is the Roman Catholic Church, or some call him the papacy. Go ahead.
Having a golden cup in her hand, full of abomination and filthiness of her fornication.
Yes, sir. You know what that cup is? It's the lifestyle. Remember we did the study on about the cups of the book? You can't sit at the Lord's table and drink of the Lord's cup and drink of Satan's cup. You can't drink of these two people's cup. You got to choose one. But most of the world are drunk of Satan's cup, meaning that they drunk of his doctrine, his worship, his celebration. Look at them. Look at Sunday. It's going to be packed with churches. Folks going to be out having all their little clothes on because they came to church, going to the restaurant to eat. Where did they come from? Who they serve? We serving the God of Israel. We here on the Sabbath. They serving this cup he's talking about, which is Sunday worship. Go ahead.
And upon her forehead was a name written, Mystery Babylon, the Great, the Mother of Harlots, and Abomination of the Earth.
She's a mother, right? So she must have some children. When he's saying mother, that's why the Roman Catholic Church is the mother church. And all the rest of them, like the Presbyterian, the Baptist, the Church of God in Christ, the Seventh-day Adventists, all them people right there are part of their church. they don't keep the whole law. Go ahead.
And I saw the woman drunken with the blood of the saints and with the blood of the martyrs of Jesus. Mm-hmm. And when I saw her, I wondered with great admiration.
Remember what I told you about this thing called, you can look up, called Bloody Mary, where they killed so many people because they didn't worship this church. If you find worshiping on another day besides Sunday, they killed you. They punished you. They put you in jail until they converted you. That's it. And it's going to happen the same way when they put out that mark of the beast. Go ahead.
And the angel said unto me, wherefore doeth thou marvel? I will tell thee the mystery of the woman and of the beast that carries her, mm-hmm. which has the seven heads and ten horns.
Yes, sir. Those are the Gentile nations that Satan ran this woman through. We've been here since Nebuchadnezzar all the way down to now. To Alexander the Great, the four generals, Alexander the Great. It's a big story, y'all. We can't cover it all in one lesson. But we're going to hit some spots to let you know that who you worshiping, is he of God or is he of this Satan, this man of sin? Go ahead.
The beast that thou sawest was and is not, and shall ascend out of the bottomless pit and go into perdition. And they that dwell on the earth shall wonder whose name were not written in the book of life from the foundation of the world, when they behold the beast that was and is not and yet is.
What do you mean they're going to wonder? Look at them wondering right here. They worship him. They walk around kissing on him. They wondering. They love him. Kneeling down before him. If you don't know this cat right here, your pastor have failed you. If you think this cat right here is holy, this is the man of sin. He's part of that organization. Now, I'm not saying that this pope right here, which is the one they got now, I don't know which pope it is, but it's going to come out of this organization. Believe that. First one I knew was John Paul II. He lived for a long time, so he went crazy. But this is how they wonder. Look at them wondering. Well, that's what the Bible means by wondering. You know Israel had to be in there somewhere. Just want y'all to get a visual of these people. Go ahead, brother.
Verse 9. And here is the mind which has wisdom. The seven heads are seven mountains on which the woman sitteth.
It's talking about the seven hills, the seven mountains. You go in history and look up where the Roman Catholic Church sits, that holds a billion members, it sits on seven hills. Billion members. Sits on seven hills. And he runs it. The most richest religious organization ever. And they parade around when he said this is the location of these, of where this church is. So you gotta do some homework in this, man. That Vatican is called Vatican City. If you go in history, it'll show you. Ask Google, whatever you wanna do, go to YouTube, say, what organization sits on seven hills? Sits on seven mountains. And they gonna come up. Go ahead. You finished with that?
Yes, sir.
Just wanna make y'all, give y'all some understanding, cause you gotta spend some time in this to get a visual of all this stuff. That's a lot. And he said, verse 9, he said, and here's the mind which had wisdom. If somebody's been teaching you this, just like my teacher taught me, I got wisdom in this thing. I know who these people are. That's why I call them out. I'm not stuttering about that. I know who they are. He said, the seven heads are seven mountains on which the woman sitteth. If you got wisdom, you know that the Vatican Church was built on seven hills in Rome. Built there. I don't have the. I used to have the stuff about it, but couldn't get it off. But let's go back to Revelation chapter 6 and verse 5. We still talking about the Great Tribulation, but we got to show you who the players are. If you don't know who the players are, he'll say, come on, my son, come over here, I'll give you some help. All you got to do is take this stamp in your forehead or your right hand. We don't give you food, we don't give you water. You just gotta worship me. If you don't have to do it, God gonna kill you dead real quick. You worthless to him if you take that. And it's in the scripture too. Revelation chapter 6 and verse 5. Let's look at a little more of this real tribulation. Go ahead, bro.
Verse 5.
What did I say?
Verse 5.
Uh-huh.
And when he had opened the third seal, I heard the third beast say, come and see.
Mm-hmm.
And I beheld and looked, and lo, a black horse. And he that sat on him had a pair of balances in his hand.
Go ahead.
And I heard a voice in the midst of the four beasts say, a measure of wheat for a penny, three measures of barley for a penny, and see thou hurt not the oil and the wine.
See, this beast or this horse who sits on a, he can control the food. And you're going to have to go to him to get food. But you can't get no food unless you have the mark of the beast on you. He's going to control it. So if you ain't in the wilderness at the time, you're going to be running around here trying to find some food. It's going to be hard for some people in 3.5 years. They're going to get through it now. Don't get me wrong. You're going to be having some people come out of it. But you don't have to do that. I'm only be in the wilderness because I might fold. I might fold. I need to be in the right spot. Go ahead.
And when he had opened the fourth seal, I heard the voice of the fourth beast say, come and see.
Mm-hmm.
And I looked and behold a pale horse.
Yes, sir.
And his name that sat on him was death. And hell followed him. And power was given unto them over the fourth part of the earth.
Mm-hmm.
To kill with sword and with hunger and with death and with the beast of the earth.
How they doing all this? They got all the power now. He said, kill with what? Hunger. You know Israel, we get a little hungry, we go crazy. Mm-hmm. A little hungry, little. Look what happened out here when the storm hit. Man, they don't care nobody, we got no power, our food was full. Now we, before we can feed them and everything. That's small, I'm telling you, that's very small. If you go into this town right here, ain't no food gonna be around. They gonna ration it all out, but you gonna have to have them all. You gonna have to have it. Just letting you know what you're up against. Go ahead.
Verse 9. And when he had opened the fifth seal, I saw under the altar the souls of them that were slain for the word of God.
Yes, sir.
And for the testimony which they held.
There's going to be some people killed for it. There's going to be some people killed for it because some people are going to have the knowledge, but they're too scared to go. They're too scared to get in the wilderness at the time of protection. So they're going to be left out here. And they're gonna have to, and they're gonna come up against them real bad because Satan's gonna kill them. Go ahead.
And they cried with a loud voice, saying, how long, O Lord, mm-hmm. holy and true, doest thou not judge and avenge out of blood on them that dwell on the earth?
Yes, sir, go ahead.
And white robes was given unto every one of them.
Mm-hmm.
And it was said unto them that they should rest yet for a little season. Until their fellow servant also and their brother that should be killed as they were should be fulfilled.
So there's going to be a lot of death going on right here. There's rest. Some people are going to get killed for this. Because they know they can't take that mark of the beast. They know it. It's better for you to die in righteousness than live to have your stomach filled. Die. Because what he got prepared on the other side, you can't get out of it, which is the lake of fire. You can't. Go ahead.
And I beheld when he had opened the sixth seal, and lo, there was a great earthquake, and the sun became black as sackcloth of hair, and the moon became as blood.
Yes, sir.
And the stars of heaven fell unto the earth, even as a fig tree casts her untimely fig, when she is shaken of a mighty wind.
Have anybody ever seen this before? Stars falling to earth. Then where the sun darkens, gloomy, light is not going to be like it is now. It's going to be dark, man.
Amen.
Go ahead.
And the heavens departed as a scroll when it is rolled together.
Mm-hmm.
And every mountain and island was moved out of their places. And the kings of the earth and the great men and the rich men and the chief captains and the mighty men, and every bondsman, and every free man, hid themselves in the dens and in the rocks of the mountains.
Because at this time, Jesus is going to open up the heavens. The clouds you got now, this is, he's above a third heaven, above the clouds, the sun, and all that stuff. All that going to be destroyed. And you're going to see him sitting on the throne looking down at you. And he's going to, at this time, these people are going to be running, hiding themselves in rocks. You know them little storm shelters, what they call them, doomsday shelters? That's what he mean. You can't get rid of them. This is what it say right here. Go ahead.
And said to the mountains and rocks, fall on us. Mm-hmm. Hide us from the face of him that sitteth on the throne and from the wrath of the Lamb.
They want to hide them from Jesus. Jesus is going to be sitting there looking. Y'all thought I thought I was a fairy tale. Go ahead, brother.
For the great day of his wrath is come, and who shall be able to stand?
And that's when he's going to take part in war. He got to get a little taste of this world, too. No, he's going to be no lamb no more. Exactly. He's going to be the word of God coming to kill. Let's go to Daniel chapter 7. Did I put Daniel in there?
Yes, sir.
Daniel chapter 7. Even folks in these Sunday churches don't hit these scriptures like this.
You're right.
They don't hit them. I tell them that Jimmy might not come back. You did your job. You worry about somebody coming back. I ain't worried about that. I'm going to get mine. Understand this, y'all. The word is put here first and foremost to scare the hell out of you. I ain't cussing. You're supposed to be hell. You will be scared of it. Scared of fear God. But don't nobody fear him. You see on the world today, they don't fear him. They kill old people. They rape little kids. They do all this stuff and go home and sleep like a baby. Because they don't fear, they don't believe in no God. I got away with it. Ain't nobody see me. That's how they feel. Because if you fear God, you wouldn't do them things.
Come on.
Because God see it all. Understand that. This is the reason why we preach it like this. Daniel chapter 7, we're going to start verse 21. I just want y'all to get familiar with these things. Because this man is saying he's going to make war, and Satan's going to be behind. And listen, well, this is the time when, before Jesus comes. And he's going to tell you how long he's going to be at power, in power. Verse 21, go ahead.
I beheld, and the same horn made war with the saints and prevailed against them.
You see what he said? The same horn, meaning that these horns are positions of power. May this time the Roman Catholic Church or the Papacy is going to have the power. The man of sin is going to have the power, and he's going to make war with the saints. And he said they're going to prevail, meaning that he's going to overtake them. He's going to kill them. And he's going to prosper. So much for you thinking Jesus can protect you anywhere. At this time, it's only one spot he can protect you. That is in the wilderness. Go ahead.
Until the Ancient of Days came, and judgment was given to the saints of the Most High, and the time came that the saints possessed the kingdom.
So he lets you know how long this man going to be in power. Until the ancient, who the ancient of days? Jesus. Until he comes. That's the only time you're going to get some type of rest when he comes. The tribulation period is going to be gone. Jump down to verse 25. But listen what this man is saying on doing in the great tribulation. Go ahead.
And he shall speak great words against the Most High and shall wear out the saints of the Most High. And think to change times and laws, and they shall be given unto his hand until a time and times and the dividing of time.
When they say time, there's 1 year. Times, there's 2 years. And a half a time is half a year. So that's 3.5 years or 42 months or 1,290 days. Right. Whichever way you want to put it, it still comes up in 3.5 years. This is when this man gonna, this is how long he gonna have power. This is how long you're going to have power. He said, he shall speak great words against the Most High and shall wear out the saints of the Most High. What you mean by wear? He's going to be killing them, persecuting them, beating them down, everything. Y'all see these little things on YouTube, how they got these ISIS people shooting people in the head? He going to do the same thing. He going to do the same thing. Because some of them people right now are going to be a part of the Armageddon. All that, man. All that. We just can't cover it all. Now I want to deal with something right here. He said he's going to wear the saints out. Let's go to Revelation chapter 12. Revelation chapter 12, verse 13. This is our only lesson. Just want you to see something real quick. He said he's gonna wear the saints out. I don't know what you don't want to do. This is what Satan gonna do. If you didn't even put the saints, we're gonna be good up. Revelation chapter 12, we're gonna start with verse 13. This is when Satan gonna be wearing the saints out. Go ahead.
And when the dragon saw that he was cast unto the earth, he persecuted the woman which brought forth the man child.
Who is the woman? Israel. The church. Every time God says the man child is Jesus, he persecuted him all the way down. Until now, he's still persecuting, trying to persecute him. How? By messing with his people. This is what he said here. Go ahead.
And to the woman were given two wings of a great eagle, that she might fly into the wilderness, into her place where she is nourished for a time and times and a half a time.
What are you talking about? Wings of, great wings of an eagle. He gonna have, that's transportation. We gonna fly, someone's gonna fly a plane, someone's gonna be on a boat. Wherever it is, he gonna give us transportation to get to the wilderness. A lot of people worried about, man, we ain't got transport, what? Passport. We don't have passport. Don't worry about passports. Believe me, they're going to be giving free trips out to get all the Negroes out of here. You just recognize your transportation. Just like the Pharaoh did with Moses and the children of Israel, he furnished the whole thing. Yeah, we gotta get Israel out here before we all become dead men. You see how they get frustrated with us now? This is what he's saying here. But the ones that kind of hesitant and not make it, look what Satan gonna do to them. Go ahead.
Verse 15. And the serpent cast out of his mouth water as a flood after the woman, that he might cause her to be carried away of the flood.
Now the flood symbolized people. You read Revelation chapter 17, 15. Waters mean people. He cast out people against the woman. Why? Go ahead.
And the earth helped the woman. Mm-hmm.